Most audio products you purchase have a frequency response listed as one of the standard specifications. Frequency responses are available for speakers, headphones, microphones, amplifiers, receivers, CD or DVD players, and any number of other audio devices or components. Some manufacturers tout having a wide frequency range, but such numbers tell only part of the story and aren't necessarily an indicator of overall sound quality. A set of headphones may list a frequency response specification of, say, 34 Hz to 20 kHz, plus or minus 3 decibels, but what exactly does that mean? It indicates that sound between 34 Hz and 20 kHz is accurate within plus or minus 3 decibels. By the time this video is done, I'll have provided you with a detailed explanation of what frequency response is. Just a word of warning, this is a bit of an advanced topic, so if you do have questions, leave a comment below and I'll answer them for you. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, but you can call me a dadographer. I've created many other videos on improving your photography, videography, filmmaking, video editing, audio recording, and technology skills. I'll link to those in the description below, and both during and at the end of this video, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading many more explanations of film, video, photo editing, and technology topics. Stay tuned to the end to find out how to get my absolutely free DSLR, mirrorless and interchangeable lens video camera cheat sheet that'll have you shooting photos and videos like a pro in no time. So, what is frequency response and why does it matter? A frequency response, which is often displayed on a graph or chart as a curve, describes how a device responds to sound across a range of frequencies. Frequencies are measured in hertz along a graph's x-axis, with sound pressure level measured in decibels along the graph's y-axis. A frequency response curve is a graphical representation of how a microphone will respond in the audio spectrum, and so how it will affect the signal's overall sound timbre. Most products list specifications that cover a minimum 20 Hz on the low end to 20 kHz on the high end, which is the generally accepted hearing range for humans. Frequencies above and below these numbers are often referred to as wideband frequency response and can also be important. The measurement of decibels indicates the maximum variation of volume level and how well a device remains uniform from the lowest to the highest tone. Think of it as a tolerance or a margin of error. A range of 3 decibels is common in such frequency response specifications. By the way, you may have experienced sounds above the hearing range of humans if you're a dog owner and you have a dog whistle. If you've ever blown into a dog whistle, you know that you can't hear anything but your dog can. That's because the frequency of most dog whistles is within the range of 23 to 54 kHz. So they are above the hearing range of human beings. Dogs, however, can hear the sound from a dog whistle because they can hear in the 40 to 60 kHz frequency range. A microphone that has a flat frequency response produces equal output across all frequencies. This type of microphone is known as a flat response microphone. On the graph, the curve will be drawn as a flat line. Flat response microphones are usually desirable for recording natural instruments such as a piano or an acoustic guitar because it means that they record all the various tones and frequencies equally. A microphone that has a varied frequency response produces differing output of different frequencies. This type of microphone is known as a shaped response microphone. On the graph, the curve will contain peaks and valleys and troughs. A shaped response is designed to enhance or detract certain applications. For example, a microphone may have a peak around 5 kHz to increase the presence of a vocal. Shaped response microphones are especially useful for reducing pickup of unwanted sound and noise outside the frequency range of a particular instrument. So why is frequency response even important? You can take two non-identical speakers with the same frequency specifications and end up hearing music played differently on each. This is possible because manufacturers sometimes use hardware or software designs that emphasize certain frequency bands over others, not unlike how you can make manual adjustments with a stereo equalizer. The amount of variation describes how the audio is affected in terms of accuracy. With respect to microphones for your recordings, whether a microphone has a flat or shaped frequency response, a frequency response curve should be a fairly smooth line, more or less. If it has a lot of abrupt peaks and valleys, the microphone probably won't sound very natural, and it may have a greater tendency to cause feedback with a PA system. Some microphones allow the frequency response to be adjusted to suit different applications. The most common adjustments are low frequency roll-off to reduce pickup of room rumble and boost in the upper mid-range to enhance the voice intelligibility. Basically, it cuts off the background noise and makes the human voice sound better. Now, if this is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, have you ever encountered frequency response issues in your recordings? If so, how did you solve it? Leave a comment below and let us know. Would you like to learn more about your camera settings to get you shooting like a pro? I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings for your DSLR, mirrorless, and video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos and videos to compete with the pros. Who knows? If you get it and you apply these techniques that I've talked about in this video, you can make a great video or film of your own. The link to get to your cheat sheet is just below in the video description. I've also created cheat sheets on other topics, such as video editing, and even now offer training courses on editing video using Adobe Premiere Pro, which is part of the Adobe Creative Suite, and very soon I'll have some others for you as well. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses below as well. Do you want to see more videos like this? Follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for more. Think what you saw was great? Like it. Do you have an opinion? Comment below. Know someone who could benefit from the information that I provided? Please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,300 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. If you've followed me for a while now, you may know that I have a community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers just like you on Facebook where I share pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work and learn from others, or who actually want to help others with their knowledge and experience. You'll find the link to the group in the description below, so join that group where you can learn even more.